Hello.
Hello, hello, hello. What up? ¿Cómo estás?
Hey. Buenos noches.
Buenos.
Buenos.
Oh. ¿Cómo estás, muchachos?
Buenos tardes.
Bonsoir, Sherry.
Good morning, guys. My name is Midley Jadis, and today we are going to be looking at God's Word together. Let's look at Acts chapter 9. We meet Paul before he listens to the calling of Christ. Now, Paul, still breathing threats and murder against the disciples of Christ, went to the high priest and asked for the letters from him to the synagogues at Damascus, so that if he found any belonging to the way, both men and women, he might bring them bound to Jerusalem. As he was traveling, it happened that he was approaching Damascus, and suddenly a light from heaven flashed around him, and he fell to the ground and heard a voice saying, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" And he said, "Who are you, Lord?" And he said, "I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting. But get up and enter the city, and it will be told what you must do." Saul got up from the ground, and though his eyes were open, he could see nothing. And leading him by the hand, they brought him into Damascus. And he was 3 days without sight, neither ate nor drank. There in Damascus, Paul met a man named Ananias, who was called to disciple Paul. So Ananias departed and entered the house, and after laying his hand on him, said, "Brother Saul, the Lord Jesus, who appeared to you on the road by which you were coming, has sent me so that you may regain sight and be filled with the Holy Spirit." And immediately there fell on his eyes something like scales, and he regained his sight, and he got up and was baptized, and he took food and was strengthened. Now for several days he was with the disciples who were at Damascus. And immediately he began to proclaim Jesus in the synagogues, saying, "He is the Son of God." I believe sometimes it takes something drastic to happen to make us slow down, re-examine where we are, and change our direction to do what God has called us to do, to believe what God has called us to believe. We're gonna look at Ephesians chapter 4. It says, "Therefore I, the prisoner of the Lord, implore you to walk in a manner worthy of the calling with which you have been called, with all humility and gentleness and patience, showing tolerance for one another in love. Walk in a manner worthy of the calling with which you have been called." He's calling us to be grounded in love and then sprouting out into zealous passion that abounds with good fruits bearing with one another in love and gentleness. He calls us to know peace that goes beyond understanding and calls us to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge. He's calling us into a life of adventure and fun and journey and dying to self and living for Christ and looking at others as Christ would look at them and looking at yourself as God looks at you and knowing that you are created for so much more than what the world has to offer. He wants to walk with you. But I fear that the reason that we can't hear the calling is because we aren't listening. We have these ambitions and dreams and these goals and things that we want to do, and we have these passions that pull us forward. But I think we're running so quick through life with our busy schedules that we are forgetting the most important person in our entire life, and that is Christ. See, out of Paul's physical blindness came true spiritual sight. So out of this season of sickness and isolation and quarantine, what will come forth? What kind of drive would we have if the calling of God echoed inside of our hearts? If we would slow down and truly dive deep into God's word and truly be a people after God's own heart and allow ourselves to listen to the calling which we are called to live, I think our entire lives would drastically change. I pray that we start to realize that God's word is more than just ink on a page, but it is the creator of the entire universe that spoke life into existence, now speaking to us. So out of this change of pace, I pray that we can slow down and listen to what we are called to be, who are we called to serve, and what are we called to do. May you have a blessed day. God bless you.